Remember cutting your knee after taking your first fall as a kid? Ever wonder how your body stopped this bleeding? To get a better look, let's take a trip through our circulatory system. Our heart pumps around 2,000 liters of blood per day. However, contrary to popular belief, blood is not just red blood cells. Blood contains other important components, including white blood cells and clotting factors. Though these clotting factors are microscopic, they are like the bricks needed to repair a broken building, making sure the worst part of these falls are the pain, not the blood loss. In normal people, we have lots of these bricks, which makes forming a clot, and eventually a scab, easy and minimizes blood loss. However, in those with hemophilia, the body is unable to produce or buy enough of these bricks, making clotting difficult. This means hemophiliacs are prone to excessive bleeding, as their bodies are not efficient at repairing. In more severe injuries, bleeding can be fatal, especially when it's internal and the damage cannot be seen. The hemophilia gene is located on the X chromosome, making it a sex-linked disorder, affecting more males than females. Hemophilia A is the most common type, affecting the gene that produces clotting factor 8. The disorder is genetically recessive in that if an individual has one normal allele and one hemophilia allele, they will be unaffected, since their normal allele is able to compensate and produce some clotting factors. Individuals with two hemophilia alleles are affected most severely, experiencing the lowest clotting factor levels and consequently the most severe bleeding, and are at risk for other health complications as a result. The most common type of treatment involves infusing clotting factor concentrates. These treatments must be administered throughout a person's entire life. However, gene therapy can provide a one-time treatment that will last a lifetime. With gene therapy, a functional gene may be inserted into the cell to deliver the functional clotting factor. This is done through the use of gene carriers called vectors. These vectors are derived from viruses, but don't worry, all viral genes are removed, rendering them harmless and strictly therapeutic. But which cells are we targeting? Well, clotting factors are produced by liver cells. To target these liver cells, the virus recognizes and attaches to its receptors to deliver this gene. The liver cell's machinery then takes over and produces the missing clotting factor. A first of its kind, Roctavian, is a gene therapy to treat hemophilia A with the use of AAV, or adeno-associated virus, holding the gene for clotting factor 8. The virus is injected once into the bloodstream, ultimately getting delivered to liver cells and allowing for the production of the missing clotting factors. In a breakthrough study done on a group of 134 male patients, this therapy was able to reduce rates of bleeding by 85%, even 2 years post-therapy. Remarkably, 96% of patients were able to live normal lives, no longer requiring replacement factor injection treatment. With the progression of science, continued breakthroughs like these can only be expected. This means infants, children, parents, the elderly, and all those suffering from hemophilia will be provided with a life free of constant medical intervention. This means they can live a life free of fear, where the simple scrape of a knee will no longer mean the end of the world.